Today, we are going to talk about the accelerated model of Hunyuan Video 1.5. Let's take a look at the overall workflow. The video we generated now is 81 frames long. The final resolution is 720 by 1280. The quality of this video is very high. How long did it take in total? Take a look, it took 5 minutes and 49 seconds. This was run on a 4090-24G graphics card. Of course, the entire process included the loading of the model, as well as a node that took a considerable amount of time, which is qWMEL. I think a running time of close to 6 minutes is very fast. This is where the acceleration model we discussed is used. What is this model? Let's take a look. If you open the official ComfyUI released Hunyuan Video 1.5 models, you will find that 2 days ago, a new version of the model was submitted. Look, it is these two. These two models are actually the same, except one is FP16 and the other is FP8. We only need to look closely at one of them. Let's look at the FP8 version. Note that its name is very distinctive. First, there is a fixed prefix called Hunyuan Video 1.5, which is clear. Then there is step and distilled. We know that it should be a distilled model and also a quantized model. Additionally, it involves some acceleration in the number of steps. You might recall that when Hunyuan 1.5 was first released, there were already accelerated models. There certainly were. But look at the names of those models. Those models' names have the keyword distilled, but not the keyword step. This means that when using that model, the number of steps cannot be reduced. When we were setting up the workflow, we also emphasized that you must use 20 steps. The ultimate benefit brought by distillation is here CFG, because we all know that setting CFG to 1 can speed up the workflow execution to some extent. Here, we will briefly discuss model optimization. There are 3 strategies for model optimization. The first is called quantization. For example, converting FP16 to FP8. The second method is called distillation. Distillation actually uses a large model to train a smaller model. There is also pruning, which refers to removing some less important branches from the model to make the model smaller and run faster. The optimization techniques we see in Hunyuan Video 1.5 are all distilled models. But you should note that the target for distillation is slightly different. For example, CFG distillation models aim to reduce the CFG, but look at these 2 newly released models today. They are aimed at the number of steps. You should have a clear understanding of this point. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub in the ComfyUI field. Running Hub is an excellent online working platform because as soon as new technologies and new extensions appear, they are followed up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which will grant you 1,000 free points. Additionally, you get 100 points gifted every day you log in to Running Hub, so you can try out your own workflows. Okay, next let's look at the workflow. Currently, the StepZian base distilled model released is only for ImageZian 2Zian video. Therefore, our basic structure is an ImageZian 2Zian video workflow. This includes both the generation part and the upscaling part. First is the loading of the main model. Note that the model I am loading now is the StepZian base distilled model we just mentioned. For sampling speed, the FP BAFTA version is used. Then, we enable the S-A-G-E attention. We have a sampling correction value here, which is the shift. Do not arbitrarily set the value of this shift. For example, since I am doing ImageZian 2Zian video at his 480p, it is approximately these 2 values. Whether it is TRV or IV, and whether it is distilled or not distilled, the shift value is Wu. So we can directly set it to 5小时 array. Moving on, we have the encoder and the VAE. These are specifically developed based on Hunyuan Video EDR5. This is the same as the workflow we discussed previously. Then we have a reference image here. It is a vertical format. But note that my entire model is 480p. So when resizing, I must set it to 480x832. Regarding our prompt, notice I changed it slightly. The prompt engineering I originally used was officially provided by Hunyuan EDR5, but I felt the motion effect was not sufficient. So I tried the prompt engineering I wrote previously based on the WAN. Models IV, personally, I think the effect is quite good, so I replaced it directly. Next up is the more important part here. First, we take the reference image and perform visual encoding on it. Note that the encoding model we are using is the one developed by Google, which we also mentioned when discussing this workflow previously. The most critical node here is the Hunyuan Video Image to Video node. It actually integrates our traditional prompt and our reference image to generate a new positive condition, negative condition, and latent space, which are then used for sampling. This sampling is also quite specific. Note that this model is a step-based distilled model. The acceptable number of steps is 8 to 12 steps. If you are creating your own video and you want to be safer, you can use 10 steps for speed. I directly used 8 steps also. The CFG must be 1.0. Some people might ask, didn't you say this is a step-based distilled model, not a CFG-based one? But you should note that all distilled models generally adjust CFG. Therefore, do not change this to 5. If you change it to 5 or 6, the resulting image might have color shifting. So the CFG must be 1.0 for the sampler, we use Euler, and for the scheduler, we use Simple. Then we perform the sampling, and we can get our final result. Look, first the action is quite rich. Look at the girl's eyes, her head movement, and her hand movements. These are all fine. This is why we use this node, because if we use the traditional node for generation, the character, although having motion, would not be rich enough. Then we move into the upscaling part. For the upscaling part, note that I am scaling it up from 480 to 720. Of course, you can scale it up to 1080, but 1080 is too slow. We are focusing on acceleration now. Generally, in production settings, 1280 by 720 is sufficient. You don't necessarily need to generate 1920 by 1080, right? Therefore, we used a 720 model here, and it is a distilled model. You should pay attention to try not to use the FP8 version. When I ran the FP8, the result was black. I don't know if my workflow has an issue, but my FP16 run was normal. Additionally, we need a latent space upscaling model here. What is the difference between these two? I have mentioned this before. This one is mainly for upscaling the latent space. Note where it is used. It is used in this node called Hunyuan Video Latent Upscale with Model. And what is this one used for? This is used during sampling. We also set its shift value to 2.0. Where is it used? It is used for sampling. So they are completely different models. After we load them, we first upscale the latent to our 720 by 1280. The important node here is the Hunyuan Video Super Resolution node. It mainly improves the resolution. Similarly, it upgrades our original positive condition, negative condition, and latent to a new positive condition, negative condition, and latent. You need to pass a reference image and the visual encoding of our reference image. This means adding the reference image as a condition into our latent and then performing sampling. We should have discussed this sampling before. It is a bit like WAN 2.2's dual sampling. The first part is used for composition, and the second part is used for refining the composition. The difference is the add noise setting. This one is enable, and this one is enable, and this one is disable. And this one is disabled. If you remember, when we previously created the Hunyuan I4 model, to demonstrate the quality, we used the 720p and scaled it up to 1080p. That process took me about 50 UTs. So I emphasized in that video that if it is not necessary, try not to do upscaling. But after using the acceleration model, you will find that the speed is much faster. We only used 5分钟 use and 49秒 econs, and that included model loading and the running time of QWVL. So theoretically, it can be even faster. I believe that with these acceleration measures, the Hunyuan model will become more competitive. But you should note that we still have some issues after upscaling. Let's first look at the generated result. The resolution is of course 1280 by 720 when zoomed in. Notice that overall there are no major issues, but at the very beginning there is more noise. Then let's look at this one. If you zoom in on this one, you will find that there is also a bit of noise suddenly appearing in this area. So although there are flaws, the overall quality is still relatively high, considering it is a 1280 by 720 resolution. What are you waiting for? Try it yourself now. Follow me and become someone who understands AI.